One last bit of advice for people as they're planning their drafts, they're staying up all night doing mock drafts till the sun comes up. What's one last piece of advice for fantasy football teaming, team building?
Yeah, absolutely. I think that first bit of advice would have been to wait on quarterback. So that's like a general principle. But I mean, having a plan is always good. Like everybody thinks that it's going to go according to those mock drafts and everybody's going to, you know, follow the consensus, but it never works that way. So trying to put yourself into the best position to not tilt on draft day is probably a good idea. And being, you know, I hear a lot of fantasy players that they ask us the question, hey, do I go running back, wide receiver? And we're always saying, you know, stay water. Like, you can't lock yourself into drafting a certain position at a certain spot, or you're not going to, you know, you're going to be tilting from that point forward when your guy's not there. So have a plan, take a deep breath, and, you know, have fun. I mean, and don't draft players that you're not going to enjoy rooting for either. Like, you know, at the end of the day, we're here to have fun. That's what fantasy football is all about.
Andy, hey, this is TJ here. I just had a quick question for you. You know, three-time fantasy football champion here, I guess I should. This is the proper way to introduce myself.
Big flex.
In a 21-year-old league here, Andy. But normally I've been very good, especially lately, at picking the right rookie running back. It started with Zeke, Kareem Hunt, Jonathan Taylor. I got all those guys their rookie years, and they all did very well for me. Got a few guys in mind, but tell me, what rookie are you looking at that you think that he's going to be the guy this year?
Man, that's such a good question. We've done a lot of deep diving on that topic and paid a lot of attention to, like, the second and third round running backs. When they get on the field, they generally outproduce the incumbents. So the name that comes to mind is Javonte Williams in Denver, because over the last, five or six years, it's like a 75% hit rate where that guy outperforms the incumbent with Melvin Gordon there. So, you know, some of the big seasons have happened due to injury. I remember Spencer Ware going out in Kansas City. That's what gave Kareem Hunt that big, you know, the big upside that season. But, yeah, I think I'd look Javonte's way. And then I might look Trey Sermon's way late in drafts, where you know that Kyle Shanahan's going to run the football and he's going to succeed doing it. And, you know, Raheem Mostert is there, but Trey Sermon may be waiting in the wings.
Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.